In creation on 14 March 2008. Creationism is making rapid progress. There is no doubt that certain religious groups are having a huge impact in this sphere. We must remember the Atlas of Creation that was sent out to French schools last year. In this brick-like 800-page volume, the author, a Turk who writes under the pen name Harun Yahya, takes the Quran as his basis for rejecting the theory of evolution. Great Britain. The world-famous press agency, Reuters, whose news reports serve 1 billion people every day, carried a story containing extracts from an interview with Adnan Oktar by Tom Hennigan, the agency's senior religious correspondent based in its Paris office. Titled, "Muslim Creationist Preaches Islam and Awaits Christ." The report said, Harun Yahya is one of the most widely distributed authors in the Muslim world. His glossy books and DVDs on religion and science sell in Islamic bookshops around the globe. He lets readers download much of his work from his websites for free. In its May-June 2008 issue, the magazine New Humanist, which has been published in London ever since 1885, carried an article about the rise of creationism in Europe. The story, by a Danish evolutionist professor, noted the impact Adnan Oktar's work was having in Europe. Before the book arrived, many had no idea there was a resurgent Muslim creationism in Europe. One thing is clear. Creationism has indeed come to Europe. Therefore, we have to take it seriously. What we have seen so far is just the beginning. The British Morning Star, publishing organ of the Communist Party, announced its unease at the rise of creationist belief with the headlines, "Rise of the Evolution Deniers," and "Ken MacLeod Investigates the Disturbing Rise of Evolution Denial in British Society." The collapse in Europe of Darwinism, the supposed scientific basis for communism, is alarming the proponents of communist ideology because there can be no communism where there is no Darwinism. With the realization of the false nature of Darwinism, communism has today lost the support it used to draw from Darwinism and is condemned to be remembered as a discredited ideology. This is what the article had to say about the rise in the belief in creation. 35 years ago, I mentioned creationism to one of my zoology tutors at Glasgow University. "Nobody," he said, "takes these people seriously." Today, another of my former tutors, Roger Downey, who is now professor of zoological education at Glasgow University, has to take creationism, or evolution denial as he prefers to call it, a bit more seriously than that. In Islam, creationism is more mainstream than it is in Christianity. The most prominent Muslim creationist, the Turkish writer Harun Yahya's books and CDs are finally produced. Germany. On 20 September 2007, daily Kölner Stadtanzeiger, published in the German cities of Cologne and Bonn, carried a report concerning the Atlas of Creation. Under the heading, "The Truth About Harun Yahya," the report by Helmut Frankenberg said, "Adnan Oktar is one of the proponents of anti-evolutionary creationism, who has the most destructive impact on evolution. The Atlas of Creation is Adnan Oktar's masterpiece. It is a rather costly book printed on glossy paper, consisting of stunning illustrations of fossils. The English language edition of the magazine Science referred to the Atlas of Creation as the most gorgeous looking attack on evolution seen in a long time. The marketing of the book has been perfectly planned, so much so that the book reached all the teachers in Cologne on the same day. It is a fact that if children and young people turn over the pages of the book, they will inevitably be influenced by its magnificent presentation. The wolf skulls, fish, insect, or hyena fossils in the atlas all send out the same message. They have remained unchanged for millions of years, and evolution never happened. The 9 July 2007 edition of the Süddeutsche Zeitung, one of Germany's main dailies, carried an article about the great impact of Adnan Oktar's works on the subject of creation, particularly the Atlas of Creation. The book provoked a wide reaction in France last spring. Thousands of copies of the book fell, as if from a lofty void, onto the desks of teachers, school principals, library curators, and editors. The book is printed on glossy paper, 800 pages long, and weighs about 6 kilograms, or 12 pounds. Its message is clear. Darwin lied. There is no evolution. God created the world, and created all at once. Russia. The works of Adnan Oktar have also had a considerable impact in Russia, which was governed by a communist regime for so many years, and in which Darwinism was literally an official policy of state. There has been a great decline in the number of believers in Darwinism. This state of affairs was discussed in a report in Russia's top-selling daily, Komsomolskaya Pravda, published in Moscow, with a circulation of 3.1 million. The cover story appeared under the headline, "Scientists Search for God." The world around us did not appear spontaneously, but was created. That paper, which was established in 1925 as the official organ of the Young Communist League, questioned the theory of evolution and covered metaphysical questions that science cannot answer. Covering the views of scientists holding religious beliefs shows that Darwinism and materialism have been dealt a heavy blow in Russia. The way that tens of Harun Yahya's books and some 70 of his documentaries have been read and watched for years in Russia, and the way that the public keep up with his ideas by downloading thousands of his works from his Russian websites, has without a doubt had a major influence on the Russian public's current turning to God. Switzerland. On 3 and 4 May 2007, Blick, one of Switzerland's largest newspapers, carried two reports examining the works of Harun Yahya. The reports emphasized how work on the fact of creation had risen to the top of the Swiss agenda. Whole Switzerland is now discussing the issue, heated and emotional.